It's time for us to talk about two basic types of neurotransmission, excitation and inhibition. Excitation and inhibition require a delicate balance between pre- and postsynaptic processes. Signal transmission is mediated by neurotransmitters that are released presynaptically and by a large complexity of postsynaptic mechanisms and signaling pathways. The processes of excitation and inhibition occur because this wild assortment of mechanisms mediate postsynaptic potentials. Presynaptically, the cast of characters is quite simple. We'll see, for example, that fast excitatory postsynaptic potentials are mediated primarily by cation-selective ion channels in the postsynaptic neuron. This happens alongside a host of other complex and diverse postsynaptic players involved in signaling pathways. Comparatively, the presynaptic terminal is less of a party. Back in the postsynaptic terminal, fast inhibitory postsynaptic potentials are mediated primarily by anion-selective ion channels. However, our simple, quiet little neurotransmitters waiting in the presynaptic terminal for their action potential are absolutely necessary to trigger postsynaptic mechanisms. What's so remarkable about them is the fact that the delicate excitation-inhibition balance throughout the brain can be achieved with just a handful of different types of neurotransmitters and ions. For example, metabotropic receptors like GPCRs will sense a neurotransmitter and activate specific signal transduction pathways that ultimately change ion permeability and other processes inside the cell. Other postsynaptic players, like AMPA and NMDA receptors, which mediate excitatory communication and synaptic plasticity in the central nervous system, are permeable to many different types of ions. The party is clearly happening postsynaptically.